Okay, assalamualaikum and selamat sejahtera. So now let's look at subtopic 4.2, which are cofactor. Okay, so first of all, what are cofactors? Okay, so firstly, you have to know the definition. So cofactor is a non-protein components required for some enzymes to function. Okay, so first of all, cofactor actually it is a non-protein. Maksudnya dia adalah molekul yang bukan protein, which is it is required for some enzyme to function. So means that if there is a cofactor, so the enzyme can function more efficient. And then cofactors can be either inorganic or organic molecule. Okay, so the concept of cofactor, if you look at this diagram, okay, so this is apo enzyme. So what is apo enzyme? It is the enzyme without cofactor. So when cofactor bind to the apo enzyme, so this is what we call as holoenzyme. So this cofactor is needed for some enzyme to function more efficient. Okay, so this is the equation. So apo enzyme plus cofactor, so it will produce holoenzyme, and holoenzyme is catalytically active. Okay, so what is the function of cofactor? Okay, so cofactor work by binding with the enzyme, and sometimes it will alter the shape of the enzyme, and also so that the enzyme can bind more effectively with the substrate. Okay, so means that if there is a cofactor, so the enzyme will function more efficient. So now we look at the types of cofactor. So there are three types of cofactor. The first one we call as metal ion activators. Second are coenzyme. Third are prosthetic group. So what you have to do for all of these three types of cofactor, you have to differentiate, okay, its types of cofactor, and also you have to give the example. Okay, so now we look one by one. Okay, firstly, you have to know each of the cofactors, how it will bind to the enzyme. Okay, for the example, the first one we call as metal ion activators. So the example of metal ion, you can give magnesium 2 plus, zinc 2 plus, and also ferrum ion 2 plus. Okay, so metal ions are metal ions, means that it is and ions. And then how metal ion activators bind to the enzyme, it is loosely and temporarily bound to the enzyme by weak ionic bond. So means that it is loosely bound. Okay, loosely bound ni maksudnya ikatan yang lemah lah, and temporary maksudnya dia bersifat sementara. Okay, so what is the function of metal ion activators? It will mold enzyme into shape, or it will allow enzyme substrate complex to form easily. Okay, so the example of metal ion activators are salivary amylase. Okay, this is salivary amylase. Actually, it is the enzyme. So salivary amylase require the presence of chloride ion. So chloride ion here is the metal ion activators. Okay, so salivary amylase require the presence of chloride ion before it will efficiently convert starch into maltose. So means that how salivary amylase enzyme can convert starch into maltose, it needs help from the chloride ion. So chloride ion here is the example of metal ion activators. So that's why the salivary amylase function will become more efficient in conversion of starch into maltose. Okay, so now we look at coenzyme. So the example of coenzyme here is NAD+. Okay, so first of all, what is coenzyme? So coenzyme is an organic substance. Okay, so remember, it is an organic substance. Okay, then coenzyme will loosely and temporarily bound to enzyme by hydrogen bond. So if you look at coenzyme, based on its attachment to the enzyme, okay, means that this cofactor, coenzyme cofactor, okay, based on its attachment to the enzyme, it is same as metal ion activators. So means that coenzyme also loosely and temporarily bound to enzyme, but for coenzyme it is by hydrogen bond. Okay, and coenzyme do not remain attached to the enzyme between reaction. So this is what we said as temporary. So means that it does not remain attached, dia tak akan kekal, okay, or readily detached from the enzyme. Okay, so the example here, this one saya dah mention tadi. So the example of coenzyme is NAD+. Okay, so what is NAD+? It is derived from nicotinic acid, which is a member of the vitamin B complex. So what is the function of this NAD+? It will act as a coenzyme to dehydrogenase. Okay, so dehydrogenase here is enzyme, is a type of enzyme, by acting as a hydrogen acceptor. Okay, so actually the specific NAD+ here, actually kita akan jumpa dalam chapter cellular respiration. Okay, so now we look at another one type of cofactor, which are prosthetic group. So the example of prosthetic group here is heme group. So what is prosthetic group? It is an organic molecule. Okay, so how prosthetic group bind to enzyme? Okay, it is tightly and permanently attached to an enzyme by covalent bond. So if you compare the three types of cofactor, only prosthetic group will tightly and permanently attach to enzyme, while coenzyme and also metal ion are loosely bound and temporary bind. Okay, so ni saja perbezaan dia nak. Okay, so if you look at prosthetic group, okay, so based on its attachment, so it is tightly and permanently attached to an enzyme by covalent bond. Okay, so the example here, okay, this one I already mentioned. So example of prosthetic group is heme. Okay, so what is the function of heme here? So in cytochrome oxidase, okay, it will involve this one is the enzyme. Okay, so means that heme here is the cofactor. Okay, so heme in the cytochrome oxidase, it will involve in the transport of electron to produce ATP in cellular respiration. So this one actually it is relate to next chapter after this, which is chapter cellular respiration. So what you have to take note here, there are three types of cofactor, which are metal ion activators, coenzyme and also prosthetic group. And you have to differentiate all of these three types of cofactor and what are the example for each of the cofactors. Okay.